Do you have problems getting a good score in the IELTS practice listening test? Perhaps you find it difficult to understand what is being said, or the accent sounds a bit funny to you. These issues are quite common and are faced by a majority of applicants. However, you can easily power through them and get that score you want. Hi, and welcome back to Leap Scholar, India's number one study abroad platform. First, let's understand the format of the test. The IELTS listening test is divided into four sections, and the sections get increasingly difficult. You only hear each section one time. The test lasts for 40 minutes, the listening takes 30 minutes, and you then get 10 minutes to transfer your answers to an answer sheet. The first two sections of the test are concerned with social needs. In the first section, there is a simple conversation between two speakers, whereas the second section is a monologue, a speech by one person set in an everyday social context. For example, a speech about student services on a university campus. The final two sections relate to educational or training contexts. Section 3 is a conversation between up to four people. For example, a conversation between a tutor and a student about an assignment, or between three students planning a research project. The final part is another monologue. It is a lecture or talk of general academic interest, such as a university lecture. Now you must be wondering if getting band 9 for IELTS listening is possible. The answer is yes. There are some things you need to do before the exam and some things to pay attention to on the exam. Before the test, improve your general listening skills. Do various listening exercises. Listen to general listening materials like radio reports, TV shows, documentary programs, and only after that, take the IELTS listening practice test. Polish your topic vocabulary. Section 3 is almost always about education. Learn all the vocabulary you can about studying at university. This way, you will understand this section better. Some things to pay attention to on the test. Word types. Skip the questions and try to figure out which type of word fits in each blank. Is it a noun, verb, adverb, or adjective? Write N for noun, V for verb, and so on. This will help you to focus on the specific word forms while listening. Understand the situation. Before each part, you will be given a short introduction. For example, now you will hear a dialogue between, or you will hear a lecture on. This information is not written on the question paper, so be attentive. Note who are the speakers, why are they speaking, and where are they. This will make understanding the rest of the recording much easier. Don't lose attention. Remember, you will hear the audio once, so worry not if you don't hear some words and pass over some questions. Leave them blank and focus on the actual part. Review those questions at the end of the section. Watch out word indicators. Listen for words indicators, such as however, but, then, finally. They help you to anticipate what the speaker will say. Don't write answers too quickly. A lot of students fall into this trap. As soon as they hear the needed information, they take it for the correct answer. But sometimes this information is repeated or corrected further in the section. Number 6. Check for silly mistakes. After each section, you have 30 seconds to check your answers. It is important to check spellings, plurals, and word forms. Remember that only correctly written answers gain points. Number 7. Transfer answers accurately. As you write down your answers, check that they fit into the correct numbered space. In other words, make sure that the answer to question 7 goes into space numbered 7. Number 8. Don't leave any blank answers. You won't lose marks for incorrect answers. So even if you don't know the answer, it is better to write something in the answer box. Read the question again and make a guess. Let's take a quick recap now. Focus on words, polish your vocabulary, concentrate, avoid silly mistakes, answer all questions, watch for indicators, and don't answer too quickly. Take care of these and you can score a 9. Easy peasy!